How's it going, boys? So today, I don't exactly know what this is, but I made it, and I really like it. It has no real purpose behind it. It just has a lot of cool cards in it that I like. So, three Search for Ascanda, four Bond of Flourishing, two Guy's Blessings, three Assassin's Trophies, two Cries of Canarium, four Gifts of Paradiso, four, two Kefnets, two Ley Lines of Abundance, not Abundance, Anticipation. Four Wilderness Reclamations, three Dreadsprouts, three Cavaliers of Gales, well, whatever. Two Liliana Dreadhorde Generals, three Casualties of R. Oh yes, this is definitely a deck and it's on the high end, but it's really cool. The only thing we cannot fit in here is Enter the God Eternals. If we could manage to do that, well, then it would be absolutely. I don't know, lavishing? I don't know if there's a correct word for that. But yeah, it's something, I like it, and well, actually, I really like it. There's also a red version of this, which is not deemed worthy by my standards, so there's also that part. Okay, so let's see what we're gonna be going up against. If we get the mana, it's gonna be fine. If we don't get the mana, well. I'm gonna mulligan this probably. And what's the deal with Ley Line of Abundance happening so much often in the early opening hand than the green light, not the abundance. I'm mixing them up for some reason anyway, mulligan. Yes, this seems actually fine to mulligan. And let's get rid of one casualties of thought. Enemy goes first, enemy's the aggro deck, I'm think I'm gonna concede. And it's a tempo blue deck. Actually, it's not a tempo blue deck. It's a tempo. Well, it's not a tempo. It's a flash deck nonetheless. Everyone saw it coming, boys. Everyone. Yep, the Spectral Sailor just happened. Well, we're gonna see. High-costing card decks are usually not the greatest thing in the world. Oh no, it's just a flyer deck. Okay, boys, crisis averted. Everyone get back into your huts and shit. Crisis definitely averted. Okay, need one black man and we can start finally producing results. We're gonna see what happens though. Okay. Ooh, what the hell is this? It's a spirit deck. I'm gonna keep that in the library for no good reason. Okay, gonna do this early on because it doesn't look like we have too many options currently of what's about to happen. We need one green mana, which is a huge deal. And yes, this is why we did not do anything. Is this guy just playing my goddamn spirit deck? Could be. Could be. Okay, so this is currently going fabulously, as you can see, because we did not get a single green point of mana, which is arguably the biggest mana that we need to acquire in life. But yeah, there is a chance we win. But that chance seems extremely slim if we don't find what we want to find. And that's definitely not what we want to find. Ah, at least we found something, boys. Not gonna lie. 10 out of 10 something. This is gonna save us for the time being, and from this we get a green mana, which means we can use casualties of war. But he has for some reason God's willing, so I'm just gonna. Actually, I'm not abandoning just yet. But it seems. No, actually, yeah, there's no need to not abandon. If he buffs, yep, we're abandoning. Okay, that was amazing, boys. Someone was playing the spirit deck. Well, ain't that a goddamn epic start? Not gonna lie. Okay, we had a chance, but the green mana did not happen fast enough. And God's Willing happened also for some goddamn reason. Who knows why? Yeah, God's Willing is an annoying card, but, well, whatever, essentially. Whatever. It's God's Willing. Too bad, too bad. We can't usually. Well, we can use Riddle of Sut, honestly, but Riddle of Sut is a 4-cost spell, so it does have its weaknesses, honestly. Oh, and this is gonna. And this looks like a Mana Flood game because there's 4 mana in the starting hand and the Gift of Paradiso. They did a small update. And from that moment onward, I have a. Is this one more? Yes, it is. Okay, so. They did that small update, and from that moment onward, I had this strange, ominous feeling. That every ooh, that's actually a good target for Assassin's Trophy. It doesn't matter if we give him a man. It's just a good oh, right. We got Assassin's Trophy, blah blah blah. Not actually using that. Okay, good, whatever. No one cares, right? Okay, so essentially we have a chance for that. Stop! Okay, and actually it's not even that bad, boys. It's actually manageable. So let's do this, and let's do actually this. This is the Grand Master Plan, boys. We're gonna use Wilderness Reclamation into a Dread Sprout, into a Glacial, whatever. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ! That's far too many MacGuffins, boys, not gonna lie. Okay, we're doing it like this in that case. Okay, and the Tappy Wappy, and let's kill this because it's a little bit more dreadful at this moment onward. And we need a blue land, an island, if you will. God, I should probably change the art style of these things. And they should honestly also make it so it's easier to change the art style of a lot of things. Oh yeah, that's the stuff. Oh, that's definitely the stuff. That's the stuff dreams are made of, boys, not gonna lie. Okay, there's a chance we win, but there's a chance we also lose. Okay, this is actually pretty good, not gonna lie. Okay, let's do it like this, and let's just do it like that. Okay, so the question is, does he get the lid of this thing? If he does, we lose. Jesus Christ. Well, actually, it dying is not exactly a bad thing. So I'm kinda okay with that. Assassin's Trophy. Well, it's a 4-4. Is he gonna attack, though? I have a feeling he could not. Maybe he's not attacking. What the hell is this? Well, he's actually attacking. What a champion. Okay, that's actually really bad. Okay, so what's our best course of action? Is it this? I think we can pull it off anyway, right? Two lands open, that means something. That definitely means something. It means we can just tap this blue land right there. And maybe, just maybe, we're gonna be lucky, lads. So, kill the land, kill the enchantment, and kill the creature. Killing this, obviously, and then we're killing that, and we're killing this, because it's the sexiest looking one. Okay, this technically gives us a chance. Technically. But also, there's the good game. Why is it a good game? Did you draw something that actually does shit? No, you did not. Well, actually, you kinda did, kinda didn't. Yeah, there's still a chance that I draw something. You can't exile my thingamajig. Well, you can obviously do that still. Ah, are we just getting ex. Why is everything as. Okay, that's actually good. That's very good. I like it. Okay, that gives us a little bit of HPs. And now, the thing is, these are not legendaries, by the way, boys. I'm not gonna lie. Ooh. Let's just swap it like that. Okay, so technically he exiles one and we're still alive, and then we just play one more and more Gifts of Parody. How is this even happening? Okay, so he's maybe not gonna even use the exile button right there. Now he's thinking about exiling. Nah, he did not exile. Good. That allows us to find something that we desperately want. Okay, a Liliana Dreadhorde General is definitely something that we kind of want. Okay, let's see if we play that. Now, if we pl actually, you know, let's do it like this. And swap this around so we can sack something, right? Okay, so now let's just do this. It's gonna give us a little bit more of HPs. It's gonna be amazing. Okay, and with this we can find the Liliana, and we can skip the second Gift of Paradiso, which is fine. Technically, this guy lost, but Jesus Christ. How the hell do you even manage to land two of these in a row? I'm not gonna lie, that's just absolutely flabbergasting. Okay, and also, we haven't hit a single search for Ascanda. There's a reason why we have three search for Ascandas in this deck, and that reason is obviously. No reason. Actually, there is a reason. But yeah, we're still not getting the searches for the Skanda. Okay, so I'm gonna do this, right? It's amazing. It's a 10 out of 10 play. No one expects it. Especially no one expects this fabulous, lavish combination of, oh, how the hell did this even happen? Do I attack with everything? I honestly feel like I attack with... Nah, there's no reason to attack with everything. Okay, so he most likely will block because he feels the sacrifice coming up. But if he blocks, he's still at a disadvantage because then everything gets sacrificed and he has nothing. And I have two cards and two scries. And if I use full control, I'm not actually sure how that works, but maybe I can flip it around and it's magical. Is he just gonna exile the second one? I think he's gonna exile some one of them. Well, honestly, that's fine. Completely fine. Yeah, here he does the exile move, it's fine. And, you know, bye-bye, Elemental Knight, Elemental Wingman. You will be missed, maybe. Okay, so now we do this, and full control. Okay, if we activate full control now, we can maybe switch around. No, we can't switch around. Damn it, I was hoping that we can switch around. I never used the full control part, so, you know, essentially. No, none of this is useful. Good game indeed. Not really. God Eternal Kefnet is gonna be useful, so I'm just gonna keep it like that, and let's just do this now. Oh, yes. And that's gonna be a flipped search for a Skanda. It's fine. It's absolutely fine, boys. Topters. Jesus Christ, that's... Actually, I need to put it in the graveyard, but that's absolutely fine. Oh. That's even more fine. Absolutely even more fine. And now I'm just gonna do this. Ah, oh, when the plan comes together, boys. Liliana Dreadhorde Generale. Who doubted it, honestly? Who doubted it? Who was so... yes, I'm gonna take that. It seems like a fine idea, right? Gonna do this. And essentially at this point, losing becomes like pretty much a chore at this point because it's arguably impossible. And you know, we have a little bit of ramp with Dead Sprout, which is pretty good. Boop, do that, and is that a... No, that's not it. I think I hear a mosquito, but I'm not 100% certain. But anyway, it should be over. It should 100% million be over. Yeah, he just surrenders. He sees the casualties of war. He sees the search for a Skanda. He feels it in his bones. Oh yeah. Good stuff. Okay, so moving onward. We died to a spirit deck and then ooh, that's a lot of rewards. Mastery tree. What are you gonna give? The shared summons. God. You know... So on the weekdays, I said that I'm not gonna do, like, the most impressive... Well, this is not the most impressive deck by far. Am I right or am I right, boys? Probably I am right. So... still sick, by the way. So, Alexa, press that bell icon. And download Sleazy Train Part 2. Because a lot of you liked Part 1, and that's 100%. This has potential to suck absolute dicks. Mulligan. Okay, this has less potential, but I like it. Okay, gonna get rid of the casualties of war, I guess? And let's just play this and see what happens. Maybe something good happens, or maybe we just lose again because reasons. Who knows at this point, right? We got a green land, so that's pretty good. Okay, so we're gonna be able to ramp up to 5 mana, which is pretty good. And let's see what this deck is. He actually played nothing there. That's pretty amicable. I don't actually know what the word amicable means, but it definitely has a seldom screw them to it. And that probably... How the fuck? What? Oh, Jesus. Okay, boys, this is gonna sound probably bad. No, there's actually nothing here. What the fuck? Game? And by game, I mean real life. Is it actually... The perfect season for small little tidbit creatures to survive at this rate. Oh no, but it looks like we're dropping the Liliana Dreadhorde General on curve, lads. Definitely one of the better things. So yeah, there's a bunch of small... I don't know what's their English name, but essentially, they're called one-day livers, because they only live one day and then they die. And Jesus Christ, how the fuck are they so many? I have that thing that does the thing. Should probably get a... Blue Land? Doesn't really matter too much now, does it? Okay. So, yeah, he has only two lands, by the way. Just one point that, well, how the fuck are there so many of those little things? Like, seriously, 2 minutes ago there were zero, and now there's like 50-ish of them. Okay, I have absolutely no clue what the fuck is happening. But it's fine. It's fine. We won a game, boys. We won a game. That's probably all that matters at the end of the day. We won a game with a cool deck and... Oh god, this is gonna be problematic. I already can feel it. Shit. So, if you're a first world person, you probably have those nets that, you know, prevent mosquitoes and shit, right? This has potential, but this has bad potential, Mulligan. I don't honestly know what we're honestly even looking for, but, you know... I can probably keep all of this, except the casualties of war. Okay. So, we're gonna have a turn 2 Bond of Flourishing, which is gonna be pretty good, which is gonna allow us to play the Kefnet, which is gonna be amazing! Oh god, it's a red deck we lost. Well, maybe we did- whoa! That's a red deck and he did nothing. So against the red deck, having a Kefnet is actually a pretty good blessing, because it actually is really good. Let's see. Oh, I actually don't have the next turn's play, so I can easily just get Gift of Paradiso and it's gonna be fine. Need to pay the 2 life, but, you know, that's still a bonus. And plus, red decks have an extreme- oh god, this is not a red deck. You know what this is? This is a feather deck. Oh god, you know what this is? This is the game saying you lose now because Dantal Vanguards don't exist in decks that- I have never won against the Dantal Vanguard almost. Because it's virtually impossible, sadly. Because the game does not allow you to win against Dantal Vanguards. It uses decks with Dantal Vanguards as a controlled, as a counter to control decks who have a decent amount of stuff and things to deal with those pesky, what's their names? God, there's so many of those small shitters. That's actually really bad. Okay, so what are we gonna do? Are we gonna drop this bad boy, or are we gonna drop the Kefnet? Considering we can do this, might as well drop the Kefnet. Honestly, this was probably a smarter choice because it searches our deck for better things sooner, but... I'm not a smart person, and everyone pretty much knows this about me at this moment in time. So, you know, let's just deal with that. Okay, so the question is, does he have anything to buff this to kill and bypass Kefnet? If he does, I'm mad. If he doesn't, still kind of mad. But yeah, Adanto Vanguards, boys. Huh? Why? Is there a point? Oh, actually, that was one of the things I was suspecting from that. Okay, do you have one more of those? Oh, you know, you just have a spark. You just have a spark. That's fine. Okay, so I'm gonna take action here because next turn we're playing this. And that's fine. That's absolutely fine. Because he most likely still cannot fully deal with everything. Okay, wait. Oh, for a moment there, I thought that we can't actually play this chug-a-lug. Okay, so... that's a 5-5. The enemy can't deal with the 5-5 profitably. Otherwise, you know, it's bad. We still have a lot of healing in our deck, and we have decent amount of removal and things, and let's see just what we get here. A Liliana Dreadhorde General is actually exactly what the doctor ordered. Let's put it like this, probably. Okay, So the Liliana Dreadhorde General is going to be amazing because it draws us a card and it sacrifices things and boopers and whatnot. And chances are he doesn't exactly have anything to deal with that. Let's see what he does though. Let's see what our enemy Kun does. Maybe he doesn't drop anything. Maybe he just drops the ten. Maybe he just buffs the 10 District Legionnaire. At this point, it could be anything and it could be nothing. So let's just see what happens. Is he not gonna attack? Really? He's not attacking. Boys, he's not attacking. No, he is attacking. Okay, do I care? Yes, I do care. I don't want exactly suffer too much damage. So he's killing this, and we're preventing phase damage, which is essentially fine. Yes, oh god, what the hell? That's actually gonna be pretty good. Okay, he doesn't scry to the top, so that's also good. I wonder what he's gonna do, because he's most likely not playing anything else. I hope that he's not playing anything else. Ooh! Man, that's a spicy Liliana, boys, not gonna lie. There's not a single one drop that these boys play in their decks, so this is gonna be absolutely fine. Well, maybe he has a land that, you know, oh, shit, he actually put something on top. That's fine, this can die. As soon as it dies, we can just get the Kefted. Okay. Okay, put that back in the deck and so let's see, a Bond of Flourishing. Do we want that? I have a feeling we honestly kinda do, kinda don't. It's fine. Let's just do it like this. I think it's gonna be fine. Okay, please don't play anything. Good boy. I like it when they listen. So the only problem is if he plays a 10 District Legionnaire, he can just instantaneously bomb rush the Liliana. But that's honestly, well, it's not actually fine in this case, but you know, close enough. We're gonna be able to deal with the casualties of war anyway. So yeah, also, the fact that this guy currently has mana issues just kind of proves that, you know, a patch happens, and, you know, it just magically appears out of nowhere. Ah, yeah, that's the 10th Legionnaire that we expected to happen. And he's obviously gonna go on our girl Liliana, which is a little bit saddening, but life is life, Lily. We're gonna get you back, most likely. Even though you have absolutely no place in this deck, honestly, but it's fine, I just put you in because I like it. Okay, so now let's just do this, and destroy land, destroy creature, and the enchantment is mine, so we're obviously not gonna destroy the enchantment. And let's get rid of this. So hopefully he doesn't have more gods willing, because that would seriously be a bummer. That would really be a bummer. Okay, it looks like at the bare minimum he has no more gods willing, so that's good. Oh, these small fucking flies, Jesus Christ. How did they just magically, randomly appear out of fucking thin air? Haven't seen them all goddamn summer long. Suddenly, bam, magic, they appear. Okay, so this is not exactly... Oh yes, this is pretty good even. Okay, and if we're lucky, we draw a good card. If we're lucky, we just draw a good card. Okay, he's crying a little bit. I have seen people play Legion War bosses in this deck. Admittedly, I call it a little bit questionable at best, but it's fine. Okay. Oh, what the fuck, this... What? This is not... That's not a fly. Oh, Jesus. How did they fucking get in? It's so annoying, honestly. Are you gonna try and buff the Legion War boss to an extent that it can actually kill the God Eternal Kefnet? That would be a little bit hilarious, not gonna lie. Okay, so... Still no search for a Skanta, by the way, boys. Well, not that it's the most highly probability of getting drawn, but that's why we have, Guy's Blessings. Okay, are you actually gonna... attack with the Legion War boss? I'm kind of okay with it, honestly, so, okay. Oh no, he's just sacking literally everything. Jesus Christ, take action. I kind of want it back in my life, a little bit. You know, just that small smidgen. Okay, So I'm gonna do this now, and we're gonna see later on what happens with the Assassin's Trophy, and this can go back into the deck, sadly, but that's just the reality of it. Okay. We're gonna play Assassin's Trophy on most likely the Goblin Oh god, it's a feather, boys. It's an absolute feather. So let's see what he does. Does he have a single card he can play in combination with the feather? Maybe not. So it's dead. It's definitely dead. Jesus Christ, I hate feather decks. They're so annoying, and if they're lucky, they just... Well, essentially, they just perform slightly better than red decks if they're lucky. But feather decks need a little bit more luck. Admittedly, this is not the best control deck against the feather deck because of obvious reasons. But, you know, still, whatever, right? Okay, we should be able to kill it, or he should be conceding any moment now, because that's just how it goes. Feather's dead, you have nothing to play, blah blah blah, blah blah blah. You obviously don't have God's Willing, that's pretty much obvious. Otherwise you would be instantaneously casting and flickering that dick in my face. But yeah, oh god, there's so many of them. How the fuck does this even happen? Also, how, why? Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus Christ. Wait, I have three spiders in my room above where I'm sitting. I haven't killed them just because I feared a day like this might happen. And you know what? A day like this is happening, and those spiders are just sitting there and being fucking lazy. There's literally small flies around them and they're not doing anything. They're not even eating anything. It's just, they're there. Also, the feathered player is pissed, but that's what you get for being a disgusting furry. Okay. So, seems to me like we essentially have a one. How hard it can actually be to just draw the search for a Skanta? Would be pretty easy, right? But yeah. Obviously, you can remove some cards from this deck and make it a little bit more, I don't know, what's the correct word for it, sustainable or whatever. But I like it like this. It's fun. I like it. And he's just AFK. 0 Ger 520. He's German. That obviously explains why he lost. A race of losers. Actually, isn't Germany like my second biggest viewer country? Hell, that would be a little bit awkward, but hell, they know how to take a loss. They're pretty much experts at it at this moment in time. Okay, so the enemy is obviously completely AFK, because he knows what's up. He knows he lost. And I'm drawing a swamp. Should probably really change the art. I don't know how it just picks the art at random, but it usually picks the worst art. But yeah, thank god for that Liliana to sag the enemy's things, honestly. Otherwise we would have lost. Well, that's just life. Okay. Still a million and one small flies, but how the fuck are they getting in? They actually seem also smaller than usually. Which is more awkward because the net's already pretty goddamn small, so they can't really go through it, and I don't actually see any places they can just bypass the net. If that was the case, mosquitoes would have bypassed the net, and, you know, that's something I am not gonna deal with in my life. I hate mosquitoes so much. Honestly, I do. If you don't have those nets that you just, you know, tape in front of the windows, you should probably go and buy them. That's even better tips than, you know, throwing out your fedora collection and, you know, throwing out the katana collection. Yeah, you know, that's just nice. Okay, a little bit until we get... Oh, we can open two packs. We can open two packs. So, Guilds of Ravnica, I predict gems. Holy shit, it's not gems. Nullhide Ferox. Shit. I needed a Nullhide Ferox, not gonna lie, boys. I actually need four of them for the deck I'm about to make. I would much rather see a Nullhide Ferox, not gonna lie. This Ajani is nice and everything, but a Nullhide Ferox is where it's at. I really need them for the deck I was actually gonna make. Yes, that's so good. Okay, so we need to get only two more, one more mythical card. That's... we're gonna probably get it. I'm gonna spend some gold. But yeah, that's for a later time. Anyway, so a little bit of lag, but that never hurt anyone. Anyway, so this is the deck. It's pretty fun. It's pretty everything. You can probably like get previous iterations. By the way, of this did not have Liliana. It just looked not the Cavaliers, but it looked a little bit different. It had some more early game removal and whatnot. But yeah, it's completely your choice how you make it. You can, you know, the very first iterations did have Enter the God Eternals, but the mana curve is already absurdly high. So yeah, that's that. Anyway, this was Quizzer Sensei. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Check out my channel. Check out the Discord. Check out the Patreon. Check out the everything. Check out the PayPal. And have a nice day. Bye-bye.